This is the power topic attachment head sitting on a bench, and you will notice it sits into a Morris taper inside the drill press. This one actually has a sleeve on it because the Morris taper on the power attachment head is smaller, so we have got the size of the spindle with the sleeve. This is the power tapping attachment head here, and there's a clutch on the back side of it with a knurled collar. I'm not sure if you can see it, but there's numbers on it, and I can actually dial in the torque I want to use. In other words, a smaller tap would have less torque and a larger tap would have more torque, so it doesn't slip as easy. Down here we have a tap held inside the end of the power tapping attachment head with a couple of set screws, so we could put different size taps in. And there is a rod sitting out the backside here that will sit up against the side of the column of the drill press, causing the mechanism inside to work. In other words, it will spin backwards until we load pressure on the tap, and then when we load pressure on the tap, this will spin clockwise or forward. As soon as we release the pressure on it, it will spin backwards, and it makes it quite easy to tap holes under power. We now have the power tapping attachment set up in the drill press, and we have the work held in the vise, and we'll start to tap it. Having a look at the power tapping attachment head, you will notice there's a tap in the end of the tapping head. We also have a rod that is holding on to the side of the column. This just helps the mechanism inside the tapping attachment head. This tapping attachment head, when we turn it on, it will turn in reverse or counterclockwise. When I load the tap down into the part, it will start turning clockwise. As soon as we release the pressure on the spindle of the drill press, that tap will start turning counterclockwise. In other words, screw itself out of the hole. On top of the power attachment head, there is an adjustable clutch, so the tap will slip at different torques. So in other words, you would want a small diameter tap to slip at a fairly easy torque, and you would want a bigger diameter tap to slip at a higher torque. Down in the part, we have the hole pre-drilled with tap drill size, and it's countersunk on top to help align the tap. And then we have a spiral fluted tap, which is what we would like to use for machining purposes. Okay, so we're ready to tap this block, and we'll put a little bit of cutting oil on the tap itself, and we'll turn that spindle on. And I'm going to run this at a very slow RPM. I would probably run it quicker, but I would like you to be able to see what's happening, so that's why I have it running slow. Please notice that this tap is turning counterclockwise, and the pressure is up against this rod sitting on the column. As I pull the spindle down closer to the block, what will happen is it will put a little pressure on this tapping head, and that tap will start to turn in the other direction and screw itself into the hole. So you can see it's changed directions, and it's screwing itself down in. You can see that helical fluted tap pulling the chips up out the top of the hole, which is really nice for machining. You saw that clutch stop it. And as soon as I relieve the pressure, that tap starts to turn backwards. And let's see if we can get a close-up of this. Hopefully you can see the thread inside this hole. Now this power tapping attachment would work really nice with a radial arm drill press, where you can easily manipulate the position of the spindle over the part if you had several holes to drill.